Three objectives that we needed to meet as the Army of God. The first one was to get Trump elected. The second one was to get him inaugurated, because they were going to try and pull some things to try to keep that from happening, which we all saw. The third one was going to be the first 4 or 5 months that he was in office, that it would be a little bit rocky. It would be kind of a roller coaster, which we're seeing now, which is where we're at right now. But rest assured that God has got everything in his hands. He's in control. There's a lot of talk about Trump being impeached. There's a lot of talk about the shadow government. Rest assured, none of that's going to, now they may try these things, but none of that's going to succeed, because this man has been anointed and appointed by God. He's not going anywhere. So I want to put that out there for the people, because some of the questions I'm getting inundated with emails from people right now about Donald Trump, and, you know, this is going on, that's going on, you know, and they would literally say, hey, we're in fear, or we're scared about this. There's no reason to be walking in fear right now. What I want to encourage the people to do is to stay engaged in the fight. This is not a time to lay down your weapons of warfare still, because we're still in this third objective, if you will. And once we're done with this objective, I believe after probably summertime, some of the stuff will definitely calm down. And then I think you'll see a sense of stability and peace come across the land. Obama is now trying to set up a shadow government. He's got 250 different organizations are set up all over the country, 30,000 people strong. So, and he's got a ton of money behind him trying to keep his policies in power. Well, none of that's going to work, because God's got a plan. God's already spoken. And like I said before, this is not a time to really fear. God told us ahead of time, the first 4 or 5 months, that this was all going to come to pass. So this should not be a surprise to anyone. So we just need to armor up and stay in the fight. I have one prophetic word that I'd like to talk about that came to pass when Donald Trump was inaugurated, and it was called Do Not Fear America, and I wrote it February 24th, 2016, and it talks about, because at that time, you know, Justice Scalia had just died. Now, I'm of a belief that he was murdered, because I believe the Democrats or the globalists, the Illuminati, whoever the case may be, New World Order, was trying to literally push their agenda to try to get another Supreme Court justice in there to stack the court in their favor just in case they did lose. So everybody was panicking when Justice Scalia had died. Well, the Lord had given two signs, and I want to give those two signs out. They had given two signs at Justice Scalia's funeral. And at the bottom of the steps, if you go back on YouTube, you can watch the funeral. And at the bottom of the steps, when they were taking the body out of the hearse and they were approaching the steps, you could hear a siren in the background. Well, they were walking up the steps, because you heard a very reverent silence there at the funeral. They got to the top of the steps, and a train horn sounded, because I get a lot of emails on this, because the prophetic word doesn't say what the signs were. It just says, did you not see the two signs that I gave? So the siren represents help is on the way, because the next justice that will be appointed will come from my anointed, the Trump train. That's what God was saying during that funeral. And everybody was in absolute, utter panic at that time, because they were so worried that Congress was going to pass another justice and stack the court in favor of the liberals. Well, in the Word, it talked about that it would be reserved for Donald Trump. And Donald Trump would be the one to appoint the next Supreme Court justice. So Congress, thank goodness, had stopped any of that taking place. And in the day that Trump was inaugurated as president, that came to pass, because they never passed a Supreme Court justice, and liberals never got away with it. So that was one that came to pass. Now, in that same Do Not Fear, it talks about the five Supreme Court justices that Donald Trump will appoint. God will use Donald Trump to appoint the five Supreme Court justices, and in that, it said that Roe versus Wade would be overturned at some point. A sign was given, and the lady who was responsible for Roe versus Wade died at 69 years old. And that is a prophetic sign right now, I believe, of what's going to take place in the not so distant future, that Roe versus Wade will be overturned. Roe versus Wade will die. The lady who was responsible for Roe versus Wade, now, in her defense, she had became a Christian, I believe, and she was turned pro-life after that. But the point being is that this is a prophetic sign that was given 3 to 4 weeks into President Trump's presidency, And that prophetic word specifically stated that Roe versus Wade was going to be overturned. So that was a huge sign that was given to the people. You know, I think what's going to happen when you see Roe versus Wade turned overturned on a national level, we're going to throw it back to the states. And this is where it's going to get a little bit sticky for the states. If you live in a blue state, they may try and keep it. If you live in a red state, they're going to get rid of it. I believe there's a huge spiritual battle over California right now. And what you're seeing taking place, it's not the people, per se, in that state that's doing it. It's the leadership. The same way what you saw happening national, on a national scale, you're going to see start happening on a state level at this point. So what's happening is that the people aren't the ones that are rebelling. It's the governor out there. You got Nancy Pelosi. You got Feinstein. All these leaderships are leading California to a very dangerous place, and the people of California need to be praying. They need to be interceding. They need to rise up, and they literally need to impeach these people who are in leadership or vote them out of office and make sure, because like we have found out through this whole electoral process, that the Democrats have been manipulating these elections, that some of these people were actually elected to that office because they may have stolen the office. So they need to rise up. They need to impeach these people, get them out of office, because California right now, the leadership is in direct rebellion with the plans of God and God's agenda. And that's why you're seeing what's happening in California take place right now. And you're going to see it in other blue zones as well. I think California will become a red state at some point, but I believe that it's going to take the people rising up and, like I say, impeaching this governor. This governor is a defiant governor. He is just rebellion in the face of God right now. Nancy Pelosi, Feinstein, all those people. I mean, California is not the only ones. We've got some other blue states as well. And then you've got the inner cities, even in the red states, that are blue. So it's a matter of, you know, going in there, educating people, bringing people to know the Lord Jesus Christ, and, you know, voting some of these people out, voting these leaders out. And I think you're going to see that begin to happen. However, you're going to see stuff like what happened in Orlando with the Pulse shooting. You may see some of those things happen in these blue zones, per se, sometimes those things have to happen to get people's attention, to make them get on our knees, to repent, to realize, hey, yeah, we are in error. You know, we need to straighten these things out. So that's what I believe is going on in California right now, because they know that whichever way California swings, they don't want California going red. The leadership doesn't, because they know that that is definitely going to be the death of the Democratic Party, which is what you're seeing now anyway. I think you're seeing a death to the Republicans and the Democrats, because, you know, God's had it with their agendas, period. He wants his agenda. He wants God's agenda in there. It's because Pizzagate, the Clinton Foundation, all of these things are going to come around, and you're going to see these tribunals break out. These people, there's going to be a lot of job openings coming up. So I want to encourage the Army of God right now that if you are called to the position of a judge, if you're called to the position of a senator, congressman, or woman, it doesn't matter if you're at the local, state, or federal levels. If you're called to one of those positions or chosen to be in one of those positions, you need to get ready to take your place, because there's going to be a lot of job openings coming up, because when that stuff begins to break and they begin to arrest these people, there's going to be this massive job openings, per se, these openings, this void is going to be created. And I believe that God wants to put his own people in those voids so that now we can begin to rule and reign on a godly level, on a level of righteousness now. So the people need to get ready for that. You know, and you know, I'm still getting attacked by a lot of people, and that's fine. You know, God told me not to get involved in any ungodly warfare. He said, Mark, you know, I just want you to give him the message. He says, you know, being a prior firefighter, retired firefighter, he speaks to me in my language. He said, I just want you to go in and I want you to do spiritual triage. He said, because my people are bleeding out. He says, give them the message. You know, if they don't want to listen to the message, they're spiritually dead. They're in the black. Move on. Don't argue with them. Just move on. There's too many people who are in the red, yellow, and green who are wounded or walking wounded that want to hear the message, but also, more importantly, will act on the message. So that's what God told me to originally do. But the attacks are still coming in, and that's fine. You know, I bless these people. You know, I don't try to pay any attention to it, and I just move through it. It's not just the left that's panicking, but you've also got a huge majority of the church that's panicking because they've lost their discernment. They still cannot discern that Donald Trump was chosen by God and that this is God's agenda that's going forth. You know, you take the immigration issue, for instance, where God was going to purge the land. God is going to purge land. He's already purging the land. I mean, they just did a 12-state sweep, getting rid of some of these criminal illegals that are in here. But some people are saying, well, it's not Christian. You know, why are you getting rid of these people? It's not Christian. We should be taking them in, this, that, and the other. Well, my answer to that is, well, when you're willing to take them into your own home, let me know how that works out for you. Because it's not going to turn out too well. Some of these people are criminal. Now, if they're here legally, that's fine. But, you know, it's like the church is still having a hard time trying to comprehend that this is who God has chosen. Purging the land is not Donald Trump's doing. It is God's doing. God's plan and agenda is to purge the land of any and all illegal activity, corruption, gangs, ISIS, it doesn't matter who they are, to get rid of all of them. It is God's agenda, God's plan. He is utilizing Donald Trump in order to do that. And that's what the church has to understand. But they can't. Too many of them still cannot comprehend it right now. So we need to be praying for the church, you know, for God to open the eyes of the church, open their ears to the plans of God and get on board with the plans of God, you know, with President Trump. Now, I understand that we don't put our faith in a man, which is would be Donald Trump. I get that. And that's not what I'm telling people to do here. However, it is our duty to pray for those in leadership and to support them. You know, whether you like Donald Trump, you don't like him, you agree with him, or you don't agree with him, he is God's chosen man for this hour right now.